Hey guys, Jacob here with ePoolSupply. Today, we've got the Pentair Superflo and the controlling wire that is a separate purchase that can actually work this pump kind of with automation. Let's dive in. All right, guys, we're back. So, Pentair Superflo VS, all right? So, very popular pump. There's one downfall with it, is it doesn't have a two-way communication with any of the Pentair automation systems out there. So EasyTouch, IntelliTouch, IntelliSync, IntelliConnect, any of them, right? You can't talk back and forth. It's gotta have relay control. So the way that that works is you have to buy this automation cable separately. Using the term automation cable on this thing is very loose in my opinion. I don't like the way that people call it an automation cable. It's pretty much an external control cable is what I like to call it. So, very simple. It comes with a plug that you actually plug into the side of the Superflo. So Superflos come with this little plug adapter over here. There's a big misunderstanding of this little plug on the side of the Superflo. A lot of people think it's like a power cord that you can just plug it right into the wall. Not a chance. Superflows require professional installation with the electrical going in the back of the motor. This little guy literally has 5 volts going through it. So it's not like it's a lot of anything at all. So what it is this little plug will actually go into the side of this little nut. So that way, if you notice, when I did that, it's directional. So you can't just jam it in there. You'll bend all the little plugs inside there. So kind of get a little force, but you'll feel it actually sink right into the socket. And then it's got a little tightening nut on the outside. So that way, if you trip on it, whatever, it's not gonna come ripping out. So now, the other end of this cable has 6 wires to it. We have black, a green, a yellow, orange, brown, and red. So, it's a lot. It's kind of weird as they put a separator in here. So it's almost like a Cat6 cable. They must think that it gets faster response time, I guess, if they have that separator in there. So it's this little white separator like a Cat6, kind of crazy. So the first two, black and red, those are your power and your ground. And then I'm gonna look at my cheater card real quick. Green, yellow, orange, brown. So green is speed one. Green, orange, orange is speed 2, yellow is speed 3, brown, that's a tricky one. People call brown speed 4, it's not, kind of is. If you look in the back of a Superflo, what we'll do is we'll include a picture of what I'm talking about right here, that way you can kind of see what I'm talking about. It's got 1, 2, 3, and quick clean, so quick clean is going to be your speed 4. So pretty straightforward, but yeah, so. This is a speed control wire. We need to emphasize that because we get questions all the time. Hey, it's not talking back and forth to my IntelliTouch. Yeah, it's not going to. This is a speed control. There's ways to integrate it with automation with relays. So you can actually wire this up to a relay on the inside of any automation panel. Or if you have the brand new IntelliSync, the Pentair IntelliSync, where it's a controller that literally just controls the pump. It actually wires into a plug, which is kind of nice. It's the first automation system that's actually meant for this pump. So look into that. We have a video on the overview and installation of that as well. So take a look at those. So yeah, this is the overview of the Superflo speed control wire. Thanks for watching. I'm Jacob with ePoolSupply.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching. Subscribe today if you haven't subscribed. Check out the links below, and we got a lot more content coming your way. Thank you.